support it as well on the motion to approve that Fiji ratify the optional protocol to the Convention on the Rights of the Child on the Sale of Children, Child Prostitution and Child Pornography. Again, I wish to assure this August House Honourable Speaker, sir, that government is indeed committed to the rights of our children and, of course, in ensuring that it's well protected as well. How? Let's begin with the 2013 Constitution, Mr. Speaker, sir, Section 41D, every child has the right to be protected from abuse, neglect, harmful cultural practices, any form of violence, inhumane treatment and punishment, and hazardous or exploitative labor, and exploitative labor, Mr. Speaker, sir. Again, it's not only in our constitution, of course, in the protocols that Fiji has ratified, we have to ensure, and this is why this motion is before the House as well, Mr. Speaker, sir, in the review of our national legislations, and of course ensuring that we complete the ratification process. And in terms of the review of our national legislations to be used as opportunities to also review the compatibility of our domestic legislations with international standards. Again, if we go through the recent Crimes Act of 2009 in terms of criminalizing offenses like Section 114 on trafficking in children, Section 117 is the domestic trafficking in children, Section 226 is the selling of minors, buying of minors in Section 227, 230 is living on earnings of prostitution, 231 is on the loiter, solicit for purpose of prostitution, and the list goes on, Mr. Speaker, sir. But what I intend to say is, of course, not only in terms of commitment, but in the ratification and ensuring that our national legislations are also reviewed. And that shows our level of commitment, Mr. Speaker, sir. From the Ministry of Defense and, of course, the police, we are doing our best, and we can see also that in our courts, there has been success in terms of prosecution on some of the cases, and I wouldn't mention it, but of course it's there in the report. But what I wish to say, Mr. Speaker, sir, is government is doing its best, but this requires a whole of nation, whole of society approach. It's not only government. It's always easy to blame government for everything that goes wrong in our country and in our society. But again, this is a whole of nation, whole of society approach. Mr. Speaker, sir, in the recent disasters, and even we are still in that state of declaration for parts of Gunaleu, having discussions with the acting commissioner of police on the negligence on the parts of parents, I'm saying we can have all the legislations, we can have all the resources, we can have all the technology, but if there is wrong attitude, then definitely it's not going to address all the issues that we face and confront in our societies. And let's take our responsibilities seriously. And let's not only continue to put the blame on government. And before I sit down, Honorable Speaker, sir, there has been a lot said too from the other side about the human trafficking and the fear that we will be downgraded to Tier 3. I must assure this August House that recently, in the cabinet meeting on the 26th of January, 2021, cabinet has endorsed Fiji's first ever national anti-human trafficking strategy. And of course, we have also reviewed and endorsed the 2011 National Action Plan of Action to eradicate trafficking in persons and child trafficking. I know what Mr. Speaker said, that we have a commitment and we have a deadline as well to report back. And we have met that deadline that was due on the 4th of February. We are honoring our commitments, Mr. Speaker, sir. And if I may speak on this, the strategy drives our national efforts, given the cross-cutting nature of this issue. Our national strategy is further supported by an organic national action plan that outlines objectives and activities that ensure our effective and coordinated response to human trafficking. The strategy and the National Action Plan, Mr. Speaker, sir, is a product of close collaboration between government, technical and bilateral partners, and most importantly, civil society, faith-based organizations and NGOs such as Homes of Hope, Medical Services, Pacific and Pacific Dialogue. Mr. Speaker, sir, the Honorable Rofilipe Tuisuau has gone to great lengths in reading out the 12 recommendations. Yes, Mr. Speaker, sir, this strategy and this national action plan have divided the 12 recommendations in two major components, particularly what's within our influence and control so that we can quickly address those issues. Five, particularly, Mr. Speaker, sir, as raised in the 12 recommendations. And of course, there are some issues where we need to dialogue, particularly with the United States of America, because of the differences in the sets of legislations that we have and the mechanics and the mechanisms that we have to support these legislations. We cannot just bring everything from the other country and put it straight into our own legislations. It has to be contextualized, and that is another challenge that we have. But let me assure this August House, Mr. Speaker, sir, that that concern has been addressed. It is work in progress. Just last week, Mr. Speaker, sir, on Wednesday and Thursday, the first training for our officials on victim identification training conducted by the IOM, International Office of Migration, was conducted at the inn here, Holiday Inn, sorry, Mr. Speaker, sir. And we have had officials from the Labor Ministry, from FERCA, Immigration, Fisheries, Water Police, the Fiji Navy, and a few others. So that has been conducted. And of course, we are also doing a data survey together with the UNODC, the UN Office on Drug and Crime, and the development of a database to ensure that we capture all forms of trafficking in persons and inform our future efforts. That briefly, Mr. Speaker, sir, is the perhaps the update that I wish to bring to the attention of the House in as far as anti-human trafficking policy is concerned, as were per the TIP report that has been raised before the House. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, sir, I fully support the motion before the House. Pinak.
Well, thank you.